Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Whichever part of the world you are in today, thank you for joining us. How is it going? Our topic of the season, embracing the enormous, where we will be discussing what life gives. You can pick up. Use our speaker for today. Let me invite your host.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for joining us for another edition of Out of the Box. I'm Naveen, your host for today. I'm going to be talking to you about the plight of farmers. Dumped milk, smashed eggs, and plowed vegetables, read the title of a New York Times article earlier this week. Imagine the plight of farmers that are having to dump millions of gallons of milk into pits and lagoons. Farmers are complaining of having to make ditches to dump their, onion. Tractors are crisscrossing across fields, plowing perfectly good vegetables ready for harvest back into the soil. Pathetic does not even begin to describe their condition. This is happening in India too, where millions of people die because of hunger and poverty. And farmers are doing this to their harvest, despite having given away more than 50% of their produce to NGOs that are supporting the poor and needy. Thankfully, there are a few good Samaritans that are helping these farmers, some of them even in our neck of the woods, to get their produce to consumers like you and me. One such person is Aladi Mahadevan, my dear friend, my classmate from school, a farmer, founder of Green Embryo, savior of farmers. He's going to be talking to you about all the things he's doing to help farmers in this period of the pandemic. I want young people in the audience to take note of all the things that he's doing and see how you can enable his work and support farmers in the ways that you can without leaving the safety of your home, by blogging, by campaigning, by fundraising, by coordinating all the work that he's doing and other people that are helping farmers. So without further ado, over to my dear friend, Aladi Mahadevan.
Thank you, Naveen. Thank you for inviting me to Beyond Eight. Beyond Eight is something which is really needed in today's world. The way we look at education has to completely change. A little about myself to everybody here. I am Aladi Mahadevan. I am an organic farmer. I've been practicing organic farming since 1995. Our farm is located near Chennai. We grow everything that is native to our place, like Chennai or Tamil Nadu, native to our place. So this is what we do.
How different would your life be today during this pandemic had you not made the shift to organic farming?
Organic farming has kept us sustainable during this crisis period. The reason being, I should first define to you all what I think about organic farming. Organic farming or natural farming is we grow nearly around 1,000 varieties of crops which we need it on a day-to-day basis. All these are native varieties which is specific to our geography. I'm talking about Chennai and Tamil Nadu. So this is what we do with organic farming. Why? Organic farming is taking us along and it is keeping us comfortable. If you notice, you are not thinking about your air travel, you are not thinking about your holidays, or you are not thinking about anything else other than your life and food now. These are the only two important things. It is only because that we are doing farming, we are able to sustain and keep ourselves very comfortable over here and quite happy over here. Yeah, it is a stay at home. We are in our farm. And that is how organic farming is helping us.
Thank you for that answer. So do you think then that this quarantine is perhaps the wake-up call for all of us to start thinking about sustainability and living sustainably?
Let us look at the past, everybody. We had the monsoons. The monsoons try to tell us something, that we are messing up with nature. we were not very serious, then came Varda. So every time the crisis is slowly coming very close to us. Nature is not going to forgive us. Nature is really getting very tired with what we people are doing. We need to be very careful about our actions, where we are moving on to. It is very important. It's not big technology that I am asking you to think. It's about very simple things like soil, air, the environment. What do you take inside your body? What do you give out? All these are very important. Once you start messing this up in terms of technology or in terms of science or in terms of anything that might come, this is not going to keep us. Today, it may look like a joke, but I'm saying we have come up to Corona. Let's not reach the stage of Marona. It's come so close to you. You have been put inside, I would say, you're in comfortable jails now, your home, that's it. It's come so close to you. That is, it's only a door that is dividing you between your life and death. We should not stretch it more.
Okay. So, how do you bring together the worlds of self-sufficiency and social responsibility through your work?
Self-sufficiency over here is we grow what we eat. We also give other people around what we grow. This itself is a big social responsibility, because this self-sufficiency as a thought and action reduces the greed in people's mind. You're very clear about what you need. And the social workers, we are trying to keep the environment clean. We are trying to maintain the soil basic on. So definitely self-sufficiency is going to help a lot of social costs.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. But you know, I'm curious, what are the real challenges and what's the most rewarding thing about enabling farmers during this period of lockdown? I'm sure, you know, the audience is also thinking about the same question.
Let me take the challenging experience first, then I'll tell you the rewarding experience, everybody. The challenging experience, okay, this is a zone where watermelons are grown around this time of the year. Chennai needs watermelons. Okay, it is summer. So, when Corona started, the watermelons had come for harvest. We went and saw that there were acres and acres of watermelons that were getting rotted. The reason is, these watermelons go to the hotels, restaurants, the big companies in Chennai. Juice shops nearly take around 24-28% of the watermelons that go from here. So, what was very challenging about this? I need to give you a small number. Five villages of around 50 farmers in each village. Small marginal farmers with around 2 acres of land each. So, 5 village, I'm talking of around 500 acres of land, and just 5 village, each acre produces around 10 tons of watermelon. So, 500 acres is some 5,000 tons of watermelon. In a district like Kanjipuram and Chengalpet, if you take all the villages, we made a small number, it comes to nearly around 120,000 tons of watermelon. These watermelons cannot be stored. The cold storage, if we put it together, we need a cold storage the size of Pondicherry. These have to be sent across within 3-4 days time. It has to be consumed in 3-4 days time. This was one of the challenging experiences. We are still working on it. As I'm talking to you, I'm trying to send it to apartments and different societies and different organizations. The rewarding experiences, you are with nature. What more rewarding an experience that you need to have? You breathe good air, okay. Personally, I am able to sit and relax on a Monday morning at 9:30, thinking what to do next. So farming is on one side a very, very, very rewarding experience in terms of mind and body. You have good health, you have a good mind. There is physical work, there is intellectual work, there is strategy, there is planning, there is engineering. So, and especially organic farming, when the whole world is moving in a direction having chemicals and other artificial methods, organic farming needs to practice very environment friendly methods for which a lot of thought, for which a lot of work is involved. It's very rewarding. So this I would call as a very rewarding experience. And coming to the end of this session, but a start where I feel everybody will, people who are watching over here will get motivated and try to explore their own path in farming. My advice, start. Let it be a small kira plant or a small dhaniya patta plant. Start. Only when you experience it, you start getting involved more.
So, I also want you to talk a little bit about the kinds of fruits and vegetables that we eat today, right? How a lot of it is grown inorganically, and try and help us, the viewers, understand how our quality of life could be a lot better if we start making better choices about the food that we eat.
Agriculture and farming has a huge impact on our environment. We have to start looking at soil, water, and other natural resources more closely. Farming today is about growing crops, how much of yield you get, how much of chemicals that you can put inside it, and how much more yield you can get, how lesser you can sell the produce. This is how the whole world is running around. But we are not looking at the impact of using chemicals, using wrong products into your farming system. So what essentially happens? I'll let you know at your home. Leave the farmers and their soil. These products which has chemicals in it, the food, the soap that we use, the cleaning liquids that we use in our kitchen. Once we finish using it, where does it go? It goes back into the earth. It goes back into your soil. So it starts seeping down into your water table. Who is going to use that water again? It is we who are going to take this water again and start using it. So what we are giving is going to come back to us actually in magnitude times with a lot more issues. So if we are conscious enough not to use products that are chemically driven, automatically the environmental impact will reduce. Sustainability of natural resources will improve. So why I am quoting this is, as consumers, if we start becoming conscious about what we are using, this again moves back to the agriculture system. Once we start saying we only want this and start talking to the farmers and interacting with them, automatically the farmlands also will not have a lot of chemicals in it. So it is because of us, what we demand, this problem is coming in. So to make it much better in terms of a better environment, better soil, better water, better air, start reducing chemical usage at our home. This will automatically impact the farming segment. They will automatically start providing you with food that is native, food that is traditional, which can be grown without using chemicals, without using pesticides or fertilizers. The world will be a better place. So once this starts happening within agriculture segment, when there is no use of chemicals, automatically the water table becomes more pure. There's more flora and fauna that starts coming in. Everybody starts being together. That's what we call as biodiversity. So this kind of an environment will start helping everybody. We will have a better world. The chances of having different problems and issues will start reducing. So this is a dream, and we have to work towards the dream. It's not something which is not possible. It is something which can be achieved if we put in our thought and mind into it. So for us to make an impact on agriculture, and not just agriculture, on the whole industrialization segment, we should start being aware of what we pick and what we use. It is our body, our skin, our mouth, our stomach, our home, our floor, our dresses. So start becoming conscious. Automatically, you will have a better environment in place.
I have to ask this one last question of you, Ladi. What can young people do in this period of quarantine from the safety of their home that will enable farmers and the work that people like you do in enabling farmers?
There are a lot of ways in which we can contribute towards this pandemic. In helping ourselves and helping the environment. Actually, we had planned having summer sessions over here. We normally have it every year, even this year. But due to corona, we were not able to bring. Otherwise, we bring in a lot of children, a lot of parents, families. They come over here, they practice farming, they interact with farmers. They learn how to interact with nature, how to be around with nature. The situation is not right for us to move out of our home, but there are various ways we can help ourselves and also the farmers around us. By helping ourselves, we help the farmers around us. That's how I would put it. Certain facts, simple facts. Our commuting time has reduced. We are working from home. So children, other than your online classes, you might have a lot of time in which you can plan a lot of things and contribute towards a sustainable world. I will suggest two things over here. One is, make sure that you grow your own food. Start with simple pots. Okay, grow your own food. You can visit our Facebook page. It's called as The Organic Farm on Facebook. Facebook.com/TheOrganicFarm. You can visit it. You can see it. We help a lot in children or anybody who wants to grow their own food. It is very simple. Start off. It just needs a few containers, small ones, big ones, medium ones. Keep it, take soil from your backyard, ask your mom, dad or parents, take some bit of soil, put it inside it. The seeds are already available at your home. It's nothing great. You have dhania, you have mustard, you have ginger, you have potato. Every tomato can give around 300 to 400 seeds. So a lot of seeds are available at your home. So collect these seeds. Put it in your containers. It will tell you how it is growing. You can see how it is growing. You will know what will grow. There will be some vegetables or some varieties of crops which will not grow properly. It may be because of your seed, or it may be because this is not an environment for it to grow. It needs a different temperature. You will start learning it. Growing your own food is a lot of knowledge that you gain about food. It is going to help you down your life. They take during this, pandemic, there are only two things that we are very closely wanting in life. One is to live. Second is food. This is what is very essential. So grow your own food. It's a knowledge. You might want to do engineering. You might want to do architecture. You might want to be an accountant. Food can give you experience in your own domain. So start growing your food. This is one way. Second is for young learners. You live in communities. Bring your community together. You have technology. You need not meet everybody. How can you help yourself and how can you help a farmer? Talk to your people. Say that you want to source your food directly from the farmers. Reach me out. Reach people like Naveen in HLC or Raji. Reach them out. We will connect you with farmers. There is technology available. We will work out the minor details now. But what happens? This is the time when you need to reach out to organic, safe food, fresh food, food which is not adulterated, which goes through minimal amount of processing, or no process in terms of vegetables and fruits and all. So once you start setting up these, why a community? Because a farmer cannot come and deliver to one home. It won't be viable. But if there are a few, 2-3 apartments or a area, geography coming together and saying, we will pick up these things, you will start getting it directly from the farmers. So it comes to your home. At the same time, talking to the farmer, you will understand what he can grow at which time of the year. So that will tell you what you should eat. We all think about the farmer's suffering, but this will directly have an impact on his life. His family will have a better living. He will also be encouraged more on growing organic food. At the same time, you and your community will get your apartment, your friends, family, relatives will get good food. This is going to help us all. And we are moving closer to a sustainable world. So again, two things. One is grow your own food. And the second is reach out to farmers through experts who are around you so that food comes directly home. Vegetables, fruits, rice, oil, all these things come directly home. And you know where it is growing. It is good to know, oh, this is coming from this farmer uncle. This is how he's working on it. You can take photographs. I can ask them to take photographs and send it across you on how they are doing it. It will be fun. And it will be a lot of learning. And it will be a lot of safe living. So try these two things. And after this interview also, you can be in touch with us. This is what we do. And we would like more people and the community to come together and be with us and be in touch with it.
Thank you so much for doing this, Aladi. I think you gave a lot of important points you covered in this talk today. I think you gave us a lot to think over. Consider the kinds of food we eat, consider the kind of support that we can all do from the safety of our home to enable farmers, and you know, the kind of work, exceptional work that you've been doing. I'm so delighted that you know, a friend of mine that I know so well for so many years is doing such wonderful work for society.
I hope it was a wonderful session. I hope I was able to give things which you can take back home and you can practice and make this a sustainable world. Thanks a lot, everyone who has attended this session. And this video, I think, would be online. I would request you to share it if you feel it's worthwhile and it's going to make an impact on the society around us. I would like to thank a few more people who are very close to us. My parents, my daughter, and my wife, who have always been a pillar of support in whatever we are doing, and they are part of this. I would like to thank Professor Sultan Ismail, who is my guru, who is my mentor, from whom I've learned a lot. A lot of things I told you today, I've learned it from Professor Sultan Ismail's teaching. You can go on his YouTube channel, you can go to his website, you can learn a lot from him. I would like to thank my team over here, Das, Murugan, Sharath, Jay Krishan, without which I don't think this farm would have been anything of what it is right now. A big thank you to Beyond 8. Beyond 8 is doing a very good job. This exactly is what is required in our education. They are trying to bring the practicality and the theory together and make sure every learner is going to take something home which they are going to make it their life skill. So it's not just me. I've been watching Beyond 8 and all their videos and all their practices for quite some time now. So a big thank you to Beyond 8 and thank you all.
I want to thank all the you know, viewers for having spent this time with us today and listened to Aladi Mahadevan. You can follow him in a number of ways. He's quite active on social media, trying to educate young people and get more people involved in understanding farming, soil, water, conservation, sustainability, just a host of things he does. There's so much to learn for all of you from Aladi Mahadevan. We will leave links for it down below. Thank you once again for joining us today. I hope you have a wonderful rest of the day. Thank you.